who's a handsome boy? Hello, scientific detectives. How may we be of service? Now, don't get too upset. Of course we're going to tell you more. Now that you know the language of living things and how they survive, it is indeed time to tell you how adaptations work. Don't worry. You're not going to hear anything else from me. I've got just the chap to tell you about it. He's an Australian, just like you. Let's watch him now.
Hi, everyone. In these videos, we're going to be looking at adaptations. An adaptation is any structure or behavior that a living thing has, which helps it to survive in its environment.
What we're going to do now is work on identifying and describing some human adaptations. First thing, our hands. We've got fantastic hands. The fingers are on one side and the thumb is on the other. Now this is a great adaptation because it enables us to use tools which help us to survive. And not just big tools like scissors or shovels, but also fine tools such as pencils and pens that we can do very clever, fine work with. Now let's look at our eyes. Our eyes are positioned close together on the front of our head. Now this is an adaptation because both our eyes see nearly the same thing, which is great for avoiding things which might get into our face, or seeing things in fine detail, or even catching things that are on the move. What a great adaptation. Humans also have big brains, and big brains are useful for solving problems and planning things. I had to plan what I was going to say in this video, and I hope that this video helps you understand about adaptations so we can all solve problems together as a community. So, our big brains are another adaptation.
Okay, so now it's your turn. I'd like you to try identifying and describing some human adaptations. There are some suggestions down below this video. What I need you to do is identify a structure or a behavior that humans do, and then talk about how that helps them survive in their environment. If you can do that, then you've explained a human adaptation. Good luck.
There, what did I tell you? Wasn't he a sterling chap? Absolutely not. I am an only child. Now, why don't you try to be a sport and have a go at the task that he set you in the video? The details are below. And in future, when you make contact, can you use your big human brain and try to use a more modern telecommunications technique? Haven't you heard of Zoom? Thank you. Goodbye.